Let's talk about some tricks how to work with different sounds from different sources during recording and editing 360 videos. Hey guys, in one of my previous videos I showed you some tricks how to record audio with different devices. Using certain cameras we can record audio using their built-in microphones or many other external mics like different lavalier mics or shotgun mics, connecting them with an audio cable. In these cases our audio is synchronized in camera during shooting. But some other cameras, like most of the consumer or even prosumer 360 models, don't have any audio input. And in this case we have to record audio separately if we want to use a better microphone than the built-in mics of these devices. And when I say better, in many cases it's not always about the quality. There can be some other aspects. For instance, if I want to record speech a little bit further from the camera, it would be difficult to capture my voice with the built-in mics. Or when I'm shooting with a waterproof case or an adventure case, the audio will be unusable. So when I'm talking about a better microphone, I don't say that these camera microphones are bad or anything like this. The point is that we cannot use them in every single case, but it's okay. In most of my 360 vlogs I always recorded audio on the scene with the built-in mics, because in a vlogging situation I think atmosphere is very important. Or when there are more than one people talking in a real-life situation, it would be hard to pass the microphone over and over again, so it's fine recording audio in every direction. But now let's talk about further situations when I prefer recording audio separately from the camera. When I want to record my voice from various distances, the best solution is using a lavalier mic. This lavalier mic can be connected to an external recorder like this, or I also like using my iPhone and the microphone of my iPhone headset. I think it's a nice solution, and you can learn more about this technique in my previous video. But now let's see some further situations when I like recording with an external recorder. The first case is when I record something really loud. The built-in mics of these cameras have auto audio gain and they don't really handle hard sound pressure. In these cases I prefer using an external recorder which can handle it and also lets me set up the gain manually. And in a concert situation there is another problem. You know, these 360 cameras have really wide-angle lenses and the 360 video looks the best when you put the camera right in the middle of the action, or at least really close to the artist. But it's not the best position to record audio, so I have to record the sound from a very different spot. And in these cases I physically separate the devices during recording 360 video and audio. So these are the most common situations when I have to record audio separately from the camera. And how to go on with it? I'll show you some techniques. The first and most important thing is to record with the same frequency rate. Most of the 360 cameras record in 48 kHz, so whether I use an external recorder or my phone, I always set up 48 kHz. That's how I can properly synchronize them in post. And the easiest way to do this in Premiere is to open both the audio file and the video with the control audio track. I put them in separate tracks. Now the video and the audio recorded by the camera are linked, but as you can see I can move the other audio separately. Now I select both files, right click, and I select synchronizing. This way Premiere finds the matching points and moves the files to the correct place. It's very important that as a default setting, Premiere always moves the file which starts earlier and keeps the other one on its original position. Now you can see when I put the video before the audio, after synchronizing it moves the video in the correct place. When I change the order, you can see the opposite process. It's good to know because when you have tons of videos and you made a rough cut using the control audio tracks, audio synchronizing could ruin your entire work if you do it in the wrong way. Let's see, when I put the audio somewhere under the clip, I press sync and... my timeline is a mess. So let's keep in mind what the correct order is. Another issue you may observe that this syncing is not always perfect. That's because Premiere can only move the audio track to the nearest frame, as the frame is the smallest unit in the videos. But in some cases this method is not accurate, because audio time units are smaller than frames. In this case it doesn't matter how you try, you cannot move the audio to the perfect position. To do this, I click on the timeline panel and select Show Audio Time Units. Now I can zoom in even more and move the audio tracks exactly where I want. Now I can show you the difference. That's how I move the audio. And that's how I can move the video frame to frame. So as you can see, one frame distance is much bigger than the audio unit. But now you can see the proper way to get a perfect sync. When I'm done, I just simply uncheck the Show Audio Time Units mode and continue editing. Now my audio is perfectly synced with the control audio track, but in some cases even the sound recorded in camera is a little bit out of sync, so the lip sync is not perfect. If I want the best result, I use claps to sync. I don't use clapper boards, I just simply clap with my hands. I turn on Show Audio Time Units option, so I can move the audio really smoothly. The point is that I can see when my palms meet, and I can drag the spike on the audio exactly to that point. So it doesn't matter if the control audio track is a little bit out of sync, the final audio will be okay. Of course, after all, in every case I have to mute the control audio track. Or I can mute certain audio files and link the external audio to the video. First, I unlink the video and the original audio pressing Ctrl-L. Then I mute the audio, clicking on the audio track and pressing Shift-E. Then I can link the external audio to the video, selecting both of them and pressing Ctrl-L again. This way I can move them together. Finally, I can export the video with the new audio track, or I can add music and any further sound effects. The point is that I can keep the 360 format by clicking on VR video option before rendering. So this way YouTube and Facebook will recognize the clip as a 360 video. So briefly, that's all about recording audio separately and syncing perfectly with the video. I thought it would be useful to share with you after my latest episode about sound recording. So I hope you like it, and if you do, please thumbs up. And for further 360 contents and tutorials, subscribe to my YouTube channel. See you soon, guys!